suffering from those post-holiday blues.
Yes.
All the alcohol, the sugary drinks, the rich food, the sunshine. They've all taken their toll, not only on your body, but also on your skin. Are you suffering from acne, puffy eyes, dark circles and lackluster skin? It can be terrible. And the side effects of holidays. Jess, are you listening to this story?
Oh,
we're all feeling the same
way. I'm struggling.
Just in general?
Just general. And I think getting back to work.
I know.
It's the pits.
Okay, anyway, how do you bring your skin back to life? We are joined this morning by our wonderful beauty expert, Domenica Calarco, to show us how we can bring our skin back to life.
Yes.
Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Tell us about how we can start, because often our skin does, it takes a big hit over Christmas, don't
it
you think?
It really does, because we're, you know, we're in the sun, we're drinking alcohol, eating a lot of foods that we don't usually eat. Sugary foods especially aren't great for our skin, and coffee as well. Sorry to say it, guys, but coffee isn't great for your skin.
Oh.
But starting a brand new year is a great chance to revamp your skincare regime in general, because you want to start from fresh.
Yes.
You want to get it going, you know, from the start.
So what can we do, though? Because you've got an array of products here, and it can be very overwhelming and expensive.
Yes.
So what are the key things that we should be focusing on?
Yes. So I think the key to, you know, getting your skin back on track is double cleansing. So not only washing your face once, but twice, both morning and night.
Really? Wow.
Yes, because the first wash is going to remove any dead skin and makeup, and then the second wash is going to really deeply cleanse. So that way, once you go in with your moisturiser or your serum, it's really going to sink into your skin and your skin's going to absorb all that goodness.
Okay, so cleansers, and we're always going to be mindful that they're affordable as well. What cleansers should we look at, and does it depend on your skin type?
Yeah, so it's all about skin type. Really listen to your skin, and if you break out or, you know, your skin tends to be quite sensitive to things, go for something as cheap as a Cetaphil cleanser, which is great. You can get that in Priceline or your pharmacy.
You use that, don't you,
Jess? Oh, Cetaphil's fantastic. Mm. It's super mild, because what am I, 47, but I still get acne.
Yes.
And that is so tedious.
Yep, acne is, you know, hormonal acne is crazy. I get it. A lot of girls contact me on social media. How do I fix my hormonal acne? I think the best thing you can do is, obviously, think about your diet, drink heaps of water, but then go for something like the Dr. Dennis Gross peel pads. They're great. So it's an alpha hydroxy acid, which will really deeply clean the skin. And when I say acid, I'm not talking, you know, bleach or anything. Salicylic acid, glycolic, they're really going to dig deep into your skin and remove all that dead skin cell.
And I suppose too, from a more, if you are seriously concerned about your acne though, it is important to go to a dermatologist or see a doctor, because there are a whole range of different sorts of medications.
There is just so much. And I think going for a more natural route, you could go for like a vitamin A serum, which I cannot speak more highly of.
Why?
Vitamin A and vitamin C are so amazing for your skin. Vitamin A in particular will help with cell renewal. And cell renewal is what's going to make your skin look, you know, brand new.
Like you.
Yeah.
Like you.
Like fresh 25-year-old skin.
And now exfoliating, because I've read conflicting things about we need to exfoliate every day or do it once a week.
Yeah.
What should we be doing?
Okay, if my facialist is listening, I don't know if she'll be happy with me, but I exfoliate every single day. And
isn't that a bit rough on
your skin? Well, I'm not using, I don't like to use physical exfoliators. If you don't want to use a one with beads in it, which beads aren't really that great, something like the Foreo Luna is great, because you can just put your cleanser on this, and by using the vibrations, it really gets deep in there.
What's the one Jess is using?
So the one Jess has...
Because I get puffy eyes. Really
puffy
eyes. Yeah,
so this is for the eyes. So Jess has the iris.
So this will help with my puffy eyes?
Yeah, this in particular helps to decrease puffiness, as well as applying the cream in a much safer way for the eyes. It's not tugging, it's not pulling.
It's tingling.
Yeah, exactly. And it's really going to stimulate that collagen. And that's what vitamin A does as well.
Because also, I don't know about you, Tash, but I've found since coming back to work, I'm so puffy.
Yeah,
and always one side more than the other.
Is that correctly?
Well, I think you're meant to use it the other way. Yeah, yeah. Oh. So just like that under your eye, like that.
Okay. It does feel nice.
Yeah. Where would you get these from? I've never seen them before.
These are stocked. These are brand new to Australia. So these are stocked in Sephora, I think. But you can look it up online. You can buy them online as well. They're really great. And what's great about this is that you don't have to replace the brush or anything. Because it is silicone, it lasts you forever and you hardly have to change
that. Does it get grubby, though?
No, it doesn't.
Just rinse it.
So just rinse it,
you
honestly.
You put your cleanser on that, then
use
it.
And use that to exfoliate.
And then rinse it.
Yeah, so there are two types of exfoliating. Pretty much either a physical exfoliator or a chemical. And if you are going to be exfoliating every day, you want to be using more of a chemical exfoliator because it's not going to be as harsh on the skin.
Now, we're talking eyes too before. Puffy eyes, I feel better. My eyes feel more awake now. But what about dark circles? Is there anything that, apart from makeup, that will help
dark circles? Think, you know, thinking about your skin first before going in with makeup is going to be key. So using something that's going to be cooling, like this Dermalogica Stress Positive Eye Cream is great because it's got the stainless steel applicator there, so it's cooling as well.
Oh, wow.
As well as this one from Estee Lauder. But using something that has retinol in it is going to stimulate collagen, therefore, you know, you're going to have that beautiful, bouncy skin, you know, nothing that's going to sag or anything like that.
What about cucumbers on the eyes?
Cool cucumbers, cool as a cucumber.
Yep.
Anything that's cooling is going to help you with that puffiness. So,
yeah, it does. And obviously, too, we're all pretty sun smart in this country.
Yes.
What do we need to do?
SPF 50.
Hat. 50?
Yep, on the face. SPF 50 on the face, you have to be using that.
Because we always, and the amount of sun damage is incredible,
the
isn't
sun
it?
Damage is insane in Australia. Like, we spend millions on trying to reduce, you know, the signs of the sun.
Yes.
Of the damage, and you could just be using an SPF every day.
Thank you so much for your great advice, as always.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much. And you can find out more information about reviving your skin at youtube.com/Domenica Calarco. Thank you once again
for
joining us.
Thank you for having me, guys.